Hi friends, today I am going to discussing about the chapter solutions. We know that solution is an homogeneous mixture of two or more components. Let us consider binary solution. Binary solution consists mainly of two components. The component present in smaller amount is known as solute, whereas the component present in larger amount is known as solvent. When solute is added to a larger amount of solvent, then we get a solution. Types of solution. Based on the physical state of solute and solvent, the solution can be classified into 9 type. If the solvent is gas, then we call the solution as gaseous solution. If the solvent is liquid, then the solution is liquid solution. If the solvent is solid, then the solution is known as solid solution. When solute is dissolved in solvent, we get the solution. First, we discuss the gaseous solution, then gas in gas, mixture of oxygen and nitrogen gases, liquid in gas, chloroform mixed with the nitrogen gas, solid in gas, camphor in nitrogen. Next one is liquid solution, gas in liquid, oxygen dissolved in water, liquid in liquid, ethanol dissolved in water, solid in liquid, glucose dissolved in water. The next one is solid solution, gas in solid, solution of hydrogen in palladium, liquid in solid, sodium amalgam, and solid in solid, copper dissolved in gold. Concentration expressions of solution. The concentration of a solution is a measure of the amount of solute that has been dissolved in a given amount of solvent or solution. Let's go through the concentration terms. First one, mass percentage. Mass percentage is equal to mass of the component divided by total mass of the solution into 100. Example, 10% glucose in water by mass, that is 10 gram of glucose is dissolved in 90 gram of water, resulting in a 100 gram of solution. Then second one is volume percentage. Volume percentage is equal to volume of the component divided by total volume of the solution into 100. Example, 10% ethanol solution in water. That means 10 ml of ethanol is dissolved in water, resulting in a 100 ml of solution. Then third one, mass by volume percentage. Mass by volume percentage is equal to mass of the component divided by volume of the solution into 100. Then fourth one, parts per million, expressed as ppm. Ppm is equal to number of parts of the component divided by total number of parts of all components into 10^6. The next concentration term is molarity, capital M. Molarity is the number of moles of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. Molarity is equal to moles of solute divided by volume of solution in liter. Mathematically, capital M is equal to WB all divided by MB into volume in liter, or WB into 1000 divided by MB into volume in milliliter. Next one is molality, small letter M. It is the number of moles of solute per kilogram of the solvent. Molality is equal to moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kilogram. Mathematically, small m is equal to WB divided by MB into WA, or WB into 1000 divided by MB into WA in gram. Next one is mole fraction, represented by chi. Mole fraction of a component is equal to number of moles of the component divided by total number of moles of all the components. Let consider two components A and B. Then mole fraction of A is equal to Na divided by Na plus Nb, and chi b is equal to Nb divided by Na plus Nb. When we adding chi A and chi B, that is the sum of mole fraction of two components, that is chi A plus chi B is equal to 1. Note, from these 7 concentration terms, the mass percentage, parts per million, mole fraction, molality, these terms does not contain any volume term, so it is independent of temperature, whereas volume percentage, mass by volume percentage, and molality are temperature dependent. Solubility. It is the maximum amount of a substance that can be dissolved in a specified amount of solvent at a particular temperature. Let's discuss what are the factors affecting solubility of solid in liquid and solubility of gas in liquid. First one is the nature of solute and solvent. Like dissolves like, that is polar solute dissolve in polar solvent. Similarly, non-polar solute dissolve in non-polar solvent. Second one is effect of temperature. If the dissolution process is an endothermic process, when the temperature increases, solubility of solid in liquid increases. If the dissolution process is an exothermic process, when the temperature increases, solubility decreases. And in the case of solubility of solid in liquid, pressure has no effect. Then in the case of gas in liquid, nature of solute and nature of solvent is a depending factor. And effect of temperature. If the process is an exothermic process, when the temperature increases, solubility of gas in liquid decreases. When pressure increases, the solubility of gas in liquid increases. Just look at this flowchart, that is solubility of gas in liquid, solubility of liquid in liquid, solubility of solid in liquid. The solubility of gas in liquid leads to Henry's law. The Henry's law states that at a constant temperature, the solubility of a gas in a liquid is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas. Also, one more definition, that is mole fraction of a gas in the solution is proportional to the partial pressure of the gas over the solution and is expressed as P is equal to KH into chi, where KH is the Henry's law constant. The solubility of liquid in liquid and solid in liquid leads to Raoult's law. There are two situations. First one is binary solution having volatile solute and volatile solvent, that is liquid in liquid. Then second one is the binary solution having non-volatile solute and volatile solvent, that is solid in liquid. From Henry's law we get P is equal to KH into chi. At a given pressure, higher the value of KH, lower will be the solubility of gas in liquid. Applications of Henry's law. First one is soda water. For making soda water, carbon dioxide is sealed under high pressure. Next one is scuba diver. And this is a pictorial representation of a scuba diver. In the case of scuba divers, on moving down, that is when the scuba divers moving towards the bottom of the ocean, the pressure will increase, so the dissolution of gas in blood also increases. When they come towards the surface, the pressure will decrease, so the dissolved gases get separated and lead to form bubbles in the blood vessel. So the blood pressure increases and the blood vessel get break. And this is leading to a severe pain condition is known as bent. To avoid the bends, the tank is filled with helium 11.7%.
and nitrogen 56.2% and oxygen 32.1%.
Mountaineers. This is a pictorial representation of a high altitude climber. At high altitude, the partial pressure of oxygen is less. So, the low blood oxygen causes climber to become weak and unable to think clearly. The symptom of a condition known as anoxia. Next one is vapor pressure. Vapor pressure is the pressure exerted by the vapor on the surface of a liquid. Just look at this picture. This is a pure solvent and this is a solution. In pure solvent, a large number of solvent molecule moving to the vapor phase and it will exert a pressure. But in solution, the solute and solvent molecule makes an interaction, so the number of solvent molecule that go into the vapor phase is somewhat less. So the vapor pressure of pure solvent is always higher than that of solution.
Vapor pressure of liquid solution, that means Raoult's law. There are two situations. First one is binary solution having volatile solute, and second one is the binary solution having non-volatile solute. Let us consider A is a solvent and B is a solute. So PS is equal to PA plus PB. Here both solvent and solute are volatile. So the total partial pressure of the solution is equal to the sum of partial vapor pressures of solvent and solute. Then PA is directly proportional to chi A, also PB is directly proportional to chi B. Then PA is equal to P0A chi A and PB is equal to P0B chi B. Then PS is equal to P0A chi A plus P0B chi B. Then according to Raoult's law, at a given temperature, vapor pressure of a solution containing volatile solute is the sum of partial vapor pressures of solute and solvent. This is the partial vapor pressure of solvent and this is the partial vapor pressure of solute. Similarly, consider A is a solvent and B is a solute. In the case of non-volatile solute, partial vapor pressure of solution is equal to partial vapor pressure of solvent alone, because here the solute is non-volatile. Then PA is directly proportional to chi A, PA is equal to P0A into chi A. Then PS is equal to PA is equal to P0A into chi A. According to Raoult's law, at a given temperature, vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is equal to the partial vapor pressure of the solvent. Here, PA is the vapor pressure of solvent and PB is the vapor pressure of solute. P0A is the vapor pressure of pure solvent and P0B is the vapor pressure of pure solute.